The project that we have here is building an airplane. And of course, we're an IT company, so you would say, why you are busy building an airplane? It's just to give students the broad possible interest in different matters where IT is part of it. And these days, IT is part of everything. It's now got aviation, medical, farming, accounting, robotics, name it, there's nothing where IT is not involved.
At the moment, with regards to the industry, sort of, I guess, like in the same way Formula One works, the top of the line, the top tier that's getting a lot of the research is your airlines.
On the other side, in general aviation, there's no development. And a lot can be done on safety of general aviation. And IT is a perfect tool for that.
Experimental aviation is the fact that you can experiment on aircraft. So this gives you a platform to do those experiments. And you involve students with fresh minds and fresh ideas.
So during this week, we had a brief introduction on aerodynamics. And then we went to see actual planes and the plane that the project would be executed on.
You can think of this plane as a research and modular implementation, if you will. So what we'll do is we'll first research new technologies and how to implement them before we actually take them into real-world projects.
So basically, we have a lot of accidents in single pilot planes, especially when pilots go above an altitude of 10,000, right?
A lot of it has to do with keeping your mind free to react to anything that goes wrong, because, you know, flying isn't unsafe. It's not dangerous, it's just it's unforgiving. You do a mistake, you can't put the hazards and pull over and sit there like, no, everything's 100% fine.
So basically what the smart camera does is it monitors your eyes. And basically what it does then is it'll then analyze, hey, is this guy passing out? Is he responsive? It'll then activate a buzzer. If the pilot does not hit the buzzer in time, it'll then pick up, hey, this pilot's passed out. Then what'll happen is it'll then connect with the integrated IoT sensors of the plane. First of all, it'll send a signal to the nearby tower and say, hey, the pilot is currently passed out. Then it'll activate its autonomous features of the aeroplane, bring the aeroplane down to an altitude below 10,000, and then wait for the pilot to regain consciousness.
Basically, when you sit there and you find yourself in the classroom, it's a lot different than where you are in the plane and with the background knowledge. So I'm just trying to tie both worlds. Rather compliment the pilot rather than try to override.
It has been tested. We are going to fully integrate it with the autonomous features of the plane.
Okay.
Currently, they are both independent systems. We've got the plane here. We've got the facial recognition system. They are both independent, and we're going to integrate them.
Normally, people just think IT and it's like, oh, a computer, but it's actually cool that we can integrate so many of those IT things in a plane.
And it puts into perspective, like, what you've been learning, it sort of shifts the paradigm.
I didn't think, yes, I'm going to be programming for pilots and planes and making sure they arrive live. But it's part of the industry now.
Apply what you specialized in to some completely different field. That's what makes a better graduate in the end.
And this project will test the benchmarks in aviation safety.